So just adapt. You go over there with one mindset, you know, and then you adapt.
There's been a lot done about this subject. Books, documentaries, feature films, novels. I mean, it's not like no one's ever tried. But it remains this kind of unfinished business in American history.
All you have to do is write one true sentence. Write the truest sentence that you know. And then go on from there.
And the anxiety that would produce of how can I live up to this? How can the next book be better? What is in me to make this real?
He really did not behave well so many times over and over again. But in working on the film and delving more deeply into his demons and his struggles, especially with mental illness, addiction, vulnerability, his self-doubt, I have a much deeper appreciation for the struggles he had and the effort he put into creating art that would last, which he did.
College, it helps us become civic beings. It helps us understand that we have an interest in our community, that our community is a part of us and we are a part of it. It is balancing two identities, right? You're a prisoner and you're a student.
This is a once in a lifetime opportunity for me. I don't care what you do. Take the computers, take the library, take everything. As long as I have my books. Exactly, they've done it before. And what did you guys do?
We wrote papers by hand.
It changes your whole outlook on the world, period. You know, knowing that this is not the end for you.
New Hampshire Humanities, hosting their annual celebration of the humanities with a virtual event on October 14th, featuring documentary filmmaker Lynn Novick. Information and tickets available at nhhumanities.org/celebrate.